The death of any man is my brother. One of the greatest writers that ever lived, Tolstoy, once wrote, "War on one hand is such an atrocious thing that no man has the right to assume the responsibility of beginning a war." Just in this century alone, America has already fought 2 world wars, a Korean War, and we are locked in a senseless struggle of death in Vietnam. Senseless, because any slaughter is senseless. Murder is wrong, whether you're mugged on the streets of a city or whether you are butchered on the battlefield. Just the other day, I read of 2 teenagers from Harlem that were killed, and the same day, there were 30 young men of the Viet Cong killed. And my heart went out to all the grieving families, black in my district and yellow in Vietnam. They have families as well as we do, and I sorrowed for them. As a great English writer once wrote, "No man is an island. The death of any man diminishes me. Ask not for whom the bell tolls. Ask not, because they toll for thee."
That's true.
And they toll for me. When we kill a man 10,000 miles away, we kill a part of ourselves. Because humanity is indivisible. Man must stop believing that he has the right to chop up another man to settle an argument. Wars aren't won. Wars are always lost. We fought all these wars, World War I, World War II, Korean War, Vietnam War, to make the world safer democracy, and the black man still lives in a world of no democracy. Man must begin to believe and act in terms of that wonderful spiritual. I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield and study war no more. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. In the neighborhood of this world, all men are brothers. War diminishes me, and war diminishes you as much as war diminishes them. Those who have fought wars and known the suffering, the pain, the destruction, are the biggest enemies of war. A great general, William Sherman, said of war, "War is cruel. You cannot refine it. War at its best is barbarism. I'm sick and tired of war." "Its glory," said Sherman, General Sherman, "is all nothing but moonshine." I don't know whether he meant liquor or not. "There's only those who have neither fired a shot or heard the shrieks and the groans of the wounded cry aloud about blood, vengeance, desolation." And then Sherman finished by saying, "War is hell." I've been a pacifist all my life. Have you made the world any safer for democracy by killing 30 million lives in this century? By burning alive 6 million Jews at Buchenwald? By lynching 6,000 black men in the United States of America? Have you made it any better?
No.
We thought we did. But Nazism and Germany, in particular, has now again reared its ugly head. And the new prime minister of West Germany, where they burned alive 6 million Jews, is now a former Nazi. So wars do not kill ideals, but only men made in the image of God. We must follow the philosophy our grandfathers who told the world to lay down. Lay down your sword and shield down by the riverside. Ain't gonna study war no more. Because wars solve no problems. They create only new ones. The seeds of international wars are sown in daily violence. The seeds of international wars are sown in the defeats. Man must begin to control his destructive impulse. That's all war is. An outlet for the evil compulsions of our society. And all we need, as my daddy once told me, the greatest power in the world is the expulsive power of a new affection. So all we need there for is the new affection of love in place of war. Oh, we can march off gloriously down the streets of New York singing "When Johnny Comes Marching Home Again," or "Let's Remember Pearl Harbor," or "The Ballad of the Green Berets." But we cannot ignore or ever forget one essential fact about war. And blood and torrents poured in vain is always in vain. For war breeds war, and the death of any man diminishes me. Ask not for whom the bells toll. They toll for me. Walk together. There is a Zion on earth. And one day, we shall enjoy the sweetness of freedom here.
Amen.
Pass this dream to your breast and make it live in your minds and your hearts. One day, one day, one day, if you keep the faith, babe,